My name is Colin Ackerman. I am the Aqualung rep for the Northwest region. I'm here today to introduce you to Aqualung's newest computer. This is the i300. This right here is an entry-level, non-air integrated computer. It's going to keep track of your depth and time and do all your table work for you so that you don't have to. It has all the features that you need to safely and comfortably do a dive. As soon as you jump in the water, it's going to turn on for you. These computers are perfect for anyone just starting in their diving career, even those who need a backup. Let me show you how it works. Welcome to the i300. This is a two-button computer. As you can see, there are two buttons. The one on the left here is an advanced button, and the one on the right is select. These computers are extremely simple to use. While they do come with a full manual, all you're going to need to use the computer is this cheat sheet right here. This ships with all of the computers, and it's going to give you all of the basic information on how it operates. But let's run through it. So if I turn on the computer, this is what it's showing. It's going to show that I'm currently diving in air, and it's going to give me the surface interval. So that you've just completed a dive, it's going to let you know how long you've been out of the water. To adjust any of the settings, the first thing we're going to do is hit the Advance button. And this is going to start scrolling through the menu. So the first menu we come to is the last dive that you've done. Right now there are no dives on here, which is why it says zero. The next, it's actually going to tell us what altitude we're at, what the current time and temperature is. So it's saying elevation 3, that's because we're here in Colorado and we're at a fairly high elevation. Continuing to scroll, it'll give us our no-fly time and what our saturation level is. So if we come back from a dive and you want to know, can I go for another dive before I get on the airplane, it's going to tell you that right here. So here we have a planning mode, access to the logbook, settings for gas mixtures, settings for alarms, settings for utilities. This is where you would adjust things such as whether it's imperial or metric, adjusting the time and date, adjusting the mode of the computer. That's going to be between gauge mode, free dive mode, and dive mode. The total number of dives that have been on the computer, as well as the serial number of the unit itself. Hit it one more time, and we are back to the main menu. So one of the first things we're going to do is put this computer into a Nitrox mode. In order to get there, I'm going to hit the Advance button and scroll through last dive, our altitude, our no-fly time, our dive planning, and our logbook, and then we land on set gas. So we've stopped on set gas, we hit the select button, and that enters the menu. We see the air symbol is blinking, I'm going to hit Advance, and that's going to get us into Nitrox mode. We can see that we have your maximum operating depth, your partial pressure of oxygen, as well as your fraction of oxygen in the cylinder. We're going to move this to 32%, the most common Nitrox mix. So as I start scrolling, what you can see, the maximum operating depth starts to decrease as we increase the fraction of oxygen. We're going to scroll all the way up to 32%. Once we're there, we're going to go back and hit select. This now lets us change the PO2. We hit the Advance button. I'm going to move this to a 1.4. Once I'm happy with that, select again. We've now finished setting the computer into a Nitrox mode, and it goes back to the main menu. Once we've finished changing the Nitrox settings, we now want to get back to the main menu. We do have a shortcut for that. We're going to push both buttons at the same time and hold them, and that'll get out of whatever menu you're in and take you back to the main menu. We're now ready to go for a dive. To give you an idea as to what the computer looks like when it's diving, let's go back to the review card. Right here you can see a picture of what the screen is going to look like. In the top, it's going to give us our depth. In the middle, you're going to have your no decompression limit. You will also have your max depth, as well as your elapsed time. When the computer is in dive mode, the only thing pushing the buttons are going to do is going to give you your Nitrox percentage as well as turn on the backlight. It's not possible to adjust any settings while the computer is diving. On the left-hand side of the screen is your ascent rate monitor. As you start to ascend more quickly, these bars will expand, and if you ascend too quickly, it's going to warn you audibly as well as with a red LED warning light that you've exceeded your maximum safe ascent rate. Let's look at some other settings that we can change. Sometimes you may be diving in freshwater lakes. This computer has a feature where you can switch between fresh and salt water, and that's found in the utility section. So we're going to hit the advanced button, and we're going to scroll until the computer says set utilities. We then hit the select button. We now have an option for switching between fresh and salt water. I'm going to scroll up to salt and hit select. The computer will activate when it hits water. That is an option that you can turn on and off. I'd like to leave that on, so we're just going to hit select and keep going. On this screen, we can change the settings. So right now it's imperial, and it lists that we're going to do the depth in feet and the temperature in Fahrenheit. You can switch that, but I'm going to keep it the same. The computer also has a deep stop feature if you're doing diving that is below 60 feet. I like to leave that on as well. The computer will automatically warn you to do a safety stop on the way up. Here we can adjust the safety stop feature. Right now it's set for 15 feet for 3 minutes. Since that's standard, I'm going to leave it there. We can adjust the light and how long the backlight stays on. It's set for 10 seconds out of the factory. And this is the sampling rate, or how often the computer is calculating your depth and time. It comes standard from the factory at 60 seconds, and I'm going to leave it there. And we're now back to the main menu. We've scrolled to the time menu to change the date and time. Hit the select button. You can change whether or not it does day, month, or month, day. And whether or not it's a 12 or 24 hour clock. I'm going to switch this to 12. Hit select, and here's the time of day. Using the advanced button, you can scroll up and change the time. By pushing and holding, it will scroll faster. There's the date. And we're back to the main menu. So those are the basics of Aqualung's new i300 computer. If you have any additional questions or are interested in purchasing or talking more about the i300, stop in to my friends at One World Dive and Travel, and they will be able to help you with all your needs. If you like this video tutorial series, please stay tuned for future episodes.